Every wildlife and bird photographer out there knows that you don't get pictures every time you are out, and it involves a lot of planning and a lot of research. And this year here, the dipper almost felt like a ghost. Suddenly I saw it, and suddenly it was gone, and I didn't see it for the rest of the day. So I was desperate to like find it again, and here I am one last time. You don't get a picture every time you are out. It's wildlife, so you never know when it will show up. And one of those trips that I had is to the dipper location, and only been seeing it a couple of times, but far, far away, but hadn't get the chance to photograph it. So I'm going to try one more time, hopefully, fingers crossed this time, something will come a little bit closer. It would be really nice. A couple of weeks ago I was out here and it was snowing, and it would be so nice to have like a dipper in the snow. That would be awesome. But now it's 30 degrees and the leaves are starting to sprout. So it's really, really nice springtime here, and hopefully, yeah, it's gonna be a good day. Time to go down here and see if I can see the dipper. I see the dipper. I see the dipper. Oh, that's a good sign. Really, really good sign. So now the tricky part is to find a good place to lay down here. Photographing the dipper this year here has been really challenging. I'm starting early this year to like scout out and see if it's still here in this stream, and I saw it far, far away, so I planned to go out and try to photograph it, but unfortunately it did not come. So now I'm here. I'm heading home actually, and I must say I had a really great time with the dipper.